Hello everyone, this is Falguni Zaveri again from Karma Healing. Today is the fifth day of Navratri and today we worship goddess Kandamat. First, let us know why the name of the fifth form of Durga is Kandamata. If you see the picture of goddess Kandamata, you will see a figure or a kid sitting on her lap. So if you see, Skand means it's a kid, first of all. And who's that kid? The kid is Lord Kartikeya. So, you know, prayers to Lord Kartikeya also helps today with the prayers of goddess Kandamata. And so what does the goddess Kandamata, praying to her, what kind of blessings do you get by that? See, when there is a kid and a mother together, of course there is this motherly love that comes, the affection, the emotions, you know, the caring, and of course the education that comes with it. So praying to goddess Kandamata is going to give you a lot of love, lot of care, lot of affection, lot of education, knowledge, and lot of good learning. So praying to her will give you all these things, and the planet that resonates with it, with this day, the fifth day of Navratri and goddess Kandamata, is again Mercury, and the color of Mercury, the Buddha, is green. So you can meditate with any of the crystals like emerald, jade, green amethyst, anything that is a green in color, crystal or a gemstone. Also, they say the planet Mars is connected to goddess Kandamata in some way. So if there is some planet that is the Mangal planet in your astrological chart that is debilitated or not sitting in the good house, you know, if you have that knowledge of it, then, you know, praying to the planet Mars will also help you a lot, the planet Mangal. So if you see, praying to this goddess, you can either do meditation with your Buddha stone, that is a Mercury. You can take jade, green amethyst, like I told you, any green stone. And you can also pray to the planet Mangal, because that will help a lot. Praying to goddess Kandamata and praying to Kartikeya, Lord Kartikeya, will also help you very much today in whatever blockages or obstacles or whatever guidance you need today. So let's go ahead and start the card reading and see what guidance goddess Kandamata is giving us today. So today what I'm going to do is I'm going to smudge all my cards and my place with the sage. As you know, so cleanse the place and the aura and the negative energies if they are around my cards. I'm going to go ahead and change it to positive energy right now. And like in every day of Navratri, I do this guidance, and today is the fifth day, so I'll be taking the guidance and giving it to you from goddess Kandamata. Like I told you, this is the blue lapis, citrine, amethyst, 1, 2, 3. So pick up any of the organites, the crystal I mean to say, that you like, and then let's go through the guidance. So I'm going to go ahead and do the cards, that is for the first one, that is the lapis. Let's see what the cards have to say. The guidance that is given for the number one, that is the lapis, is there are good things coming. The goddess is telling you that you have been blessed by the divine energy. There will be new relationship coming your way, but you have to be very careful with the health of the health of some person whom you are close to. So she is telling you to be little careful and with the health of your close ones, but she is saying that she is seeing a lot of progress and a lot of new relationship coming your way, and she is there to help you in every way she can. Her blessings are always with you, and she is telling you to go ahead and try and, you know, take the relationship that comes. and there are very good relationships that are going to come your way. So just go ahead and accept the relationship that comes your way with open hands. Lot of divine energy is coming your way, and you are going to progress with the blessings. Now let's go ahead and do the second one, that is the citrine, this organite, the yellow one, yellow orangish one. Let's see the guidance given to them. If you see the guidance, the cards, again, somewhere, you know, there are a lot of emotional cards, there are a lot of cards, the cup cards that are coming. So there is some, the lot of things related to emotions. So relationships, emotions, everything. So the goddess here trying to tell to the people who have selected the citrine, this, the second number, is you have you know, stop going out, making new relationships. She is telling you to go out and meet people. You are like not trying hard enough to go ahead and you can say make friends or meet your colleagues or have new relationship in your life. So you are right now just sitting, doing nothing. That's what she's trying to tell you. So just go ahead and go out, try your luck, try your best. She's trying to tell you ke go and push yourself in the direction and success will be yours. Also, her guidance to you is unless you work hard, you are not going to get what you want. So you have to get going, go out, meet people, meet new people and everyone, and then, you know, you start working. Once you start working, you will see a lot of difference. Somewhere she is telling you that you are right now in a very low phase where you know, you have a little bit of financial problems that is coming your way, but then it is up to you to do the hard work. If you don't go ahead and do the hard work, she cannot also help you. She is with you, she's telling you, but with her help and your hard work, you can definitely move ahead. She is also hinting you on some of your hidden enemies. She's telling you okay, there are some hidden enemies who are not your well-wishers. So you have to be very careful with them. She's telling you to trust her, and she will always come and protect you as a mother. She loves you and she cares for you. So now we'll go ahead and do the amethyst, that is the third pile, the purple one. See, again, there's a relationship card that has come in the third pile. So you're also, she's guiding the people who have chose the amethyst card, is that there is new relationship coming your way. You know, the relationship or whatever relationship you are in right now is going to get much, much better. You are going to see that happiness. You are blessed with love, you know. So the motherly love again is coming in this card reading from her. She is telling you that staying with family, staying with elders will give you more prosperity, more love, more caring kind of a nature. So always stay in a family, you know, that is kind of together, staying together. You like more people in your family. You like, you can say like a joint family, you know, it makes you happy. So she says, she's suggesting you to surround yourself with good people, your family, the people you love, and it will make your life much better. She sees a progress. She's saying, yes, there is a progress. That is like, there is a slow growth, but you are growing. So that is a very good sign that she's giving you. She's telling you to love yourself. And, you know, build new relationship that is already coming your way. So you are, you know, getting better at it, and you will be blessed by her. So the mother blessing, the mother's blessing is always with you. The goddess is blessing you with divine energies also. And she loves you and she tells you to take care of yourself. So that's it for today. Today is the fifth day of Navratri. We have done the guidance card for Navratri for the fifth day. I will come back tomorrow for the sixth day. Like I told you, do like and subscribe my channel, the YouTube channel, and I am on Instagram and FB. So please go ahead and like my page there also. So take care, all of you. Stay safe, and I will see you tomorrow on the sixth day of Navaratri. Thank you.